question is, how do we do it and what do we do? We have to pay attention to reality. We can't, you know, recreate the past. We need to create a foundation for the future. Sometimes you don't have a choice. You know, perfection is the enemy of progress. And I think we don't need a perfect bill. We just need something that stimulates the economy and helps keep people working or gets them back to work. So, you know, in terms of moving forward, once these bills are passed, just look at the stimulus bill and the $1,200 checks. The Treasury Department is saying, you know, 3 weeks, that's just not gonna work. People are scared. People have lost their jobs. Millions, if not tens of millions of people have already lost their jobs, you know, are applying for unemployment benefits. They need that $1,200 checks to give them some semblance of control over their lives, to know that they can put food on the table for their family. You can already see some cracks in the armor in terms of execution. And I think we as American people have got to push them. I know I've been really active in trying to work with small, medium-sized banks. You know, we mentioned off air that we're working with Edmunds Bank, and you can follow my tweets on M. Cuban. And they've actually put together a really good program, but just for their depositors, that allow their depositors to get overdraft protection that'll be refunded, that'll be paid back to the bank when the $1,200 checks come through. Hopefully other banks will follow their lead and do the exact same things, because we can't depend on government to execute quickly enough for all this stimulus to have impact. There are issues for every company of every size, but small business always takes the brunt of it because they live, you know, month to month. I mean, I remember my first company just being excited. I was in business 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. And when you have a cataclysmic event like we're going through right now, it's just very, very difficult to stay in business. And the thing people, there's two things people really need to be cognizant of. One, the fact that the new stimulus bill passed, and for small businesses, it includes a payroll protection program. And that's just now getting rolled out to banks, and all the details are being given by the SBA to banks. And what that does, it says for any small business with 500 or fewer employees, you can apply through your bank, not the SBA.gov site, but through your bank. And if you commit to, for under 500 employees, apply through your bank, and you can borrow enough to pay your payroll for up to 3 months for all employees who make $100,000 or less. And if you, and plus your utilities, plus your rent, and plus some incremental expenses, and if you commit to retain all your employees as of today, then you don't have to pay it back. It literally is the best stimulus bill ever for small businesses. So if you're an entrepreneur, if you're a small business operator, you need to be cognizant of this and you need to apply ASAP. That's number one. Number two is, there's companies that are actually doing okay. You know, grocery stores, if you sell toilet paper, I have a company, Dude Wipes, that sells an alternative to toilet paper. If you sell, I have a company, Shark Tank company, Mush, that sells oatmeal that can be stored in your fridge or pantry, whatever. If you sell products like that, that we can put in our pantries, that we want to keep at home, your business is actually doing well. So if you've lost your job and you're looking to replace it, look at, you know, those types of companies. Or if you're a service provider, you're a contractor that does creative work, you do videos, whatever it may be, social media, look for those type of companies, because there are some companies that are doing well and you want to try to go to them and see if you can work with them. The reality these days is that what you do as a company today is how you will be branded for the next decade, if not more. How you treat your employees will be defined, how your company is considered, and whether or not people will do business with you for a long, long time. You know, the Simons are a little different position, just because they have real estate and that's just getting crushed. But in particular, for small and medium-sized businesses, recognizing that you probably are going to be able to get this payroll protection plan from the SBA, do everything possible to keep your employees on payroll. That's part one. Part two, everybody's stressed right now. Everybody, the entrepreneurs, the owners of these companies, employees, you have to communicate. You know, I've talked to a lot of people who have said, you know what, so many people in my company have been laid off, and all we got was an email saying, you know, you're being furloughed or laid off or fired. You can't do that. That is the biggest mistake you can make. You can't fire people by email in this period. You've got to communicate. Even if you have 1,000 employees, you have to work through HR and touch each one of them personally. And if you're concerned that you might lose your job and you work for a small or medium-sized company, maybe that doesn't have an HR department, you have to be proactive and talk to your boss and talk maybe to the CEO or the owner of the company and say, you know, what can we do to work together? Everybody is terrified. This is not unique just to employees, and it's not unique just to small business owners. But communication has to be involved, because it may well be that the best idea comes from an employee who says, you know what about this idea? I think we can handle it, because the people on the front lines, the people who deal with your customers, the people who deal with all the employees in your organization, they probably are going to have a better handle on how everybody feels than the CEO. So communications is key. Transparency is key. You can't BS people. You know, all business is going to be fine, and then all of a sudden you're laying people off. No, be brutally honest. Just small business has such an impact on this country. If you're the CEO, or even if you're just a line employee, speak up, communicate, share your ideas, because this is where we need the greatest ideas, and you never know where they're going to come from.